Hello, planet Earth. Welcome to my YouTube channel. We're at IDK, my BFF Jill 730. I'm Preston L. Young, wishing you warm salutations and congratulations as always. You've made your way to the Buffington Post. Today I will be continuing my season 9 coverage of the Buffyverse with Angel and Faith, season 9, issue number 14, its family reunion, part 4, the conclusion. Let's talk about this cover real quick because it's pretty dope. I don't even know what the traditional cover looks like because when I saw this variant, I fell in love, and it's really nice because it says something about what our characters are going through. You know, there's no place like home, and who do we have here? We've got Faith. She really hasn't had any place to call home for most of her life. I mean, we see from her father, Pat, in the last arc, that her home life was never really great. She had this drunken mother and this criminal father, and life is just not great at home for Faith. You know, she went to Sunnydale, not her home, totally Buffy's home. Then she went to prison, and she came out, went back to Sunnydale, still Buffy's home, not hers. And she just kind of meandered her way through the world, and then she finally got this home from Giles, and he's like, "Oh, hey, I'm dead now." So, what the fuck? It's like Faith has no sense of home. And we've also got Willow, who's like, oh, well, how am I supposed to feel at home without, you know, the heart? Home is where the heart is. And Buffy literally destroyed the heart of all magic. And that's what Willow's trying to get back. She's trying to get the sense of home back. And you've got Connor. He grew up in this fucking hell dimension. He came back. He was all crazy. Then he went and had this like special fake memory home. Now that's been stripped away, and now Angel's back, but God knows he's not going to stick around forever. So he's back in this crazy hell home that he's had to kind of come to terms with. And now he's back there, and it's all just fucked up for Connor. And we've got Angel, who literally destroys every home that he builds for himself. This guy cannot stop like getting his shit like blown up by himself. So like, what is home? What does it mean to our characters? And how the hell are we gonna get back there? So, previously on Angel and Faith.
Willow left San Francisco to try and figure out how to put magic back together, which led her to Angel. Angel's been collecting different pieces of Rupert Giles' soul so that he can bring him back to life in this world without magic. It's complicated, but magical items retain their magical properties. Faith has gone with Angel and Willow to go and get Connor because Connor's blood will allow Willow to open up a rift into Gortok. So they go to Gortok to get some magic for Willow to bring back over into our world and figure out how to plant like a new seed of wonder, basically. And yeah, they all whipped Gortok, and then Gortok itself started to attack everybody when they were trying to rescue these dingo demons that worship Connor, okay? And holy shit, Willow was helping us fight off the old one, Gortok, but now she's gone all Dark Willow and Dark Willow back.
So let's see if we can't fix Willow and go the hell home in Angel and Faith, Season 9, Issue Number 14, Family Reunion, Part 4, The Conclusion. There we go. So the interesting thing about this is Dark Willow is like the biggest of the bads that isn't like Wolfram and Hart. Like, magic is pretty scary. You can do basically anything with it. I talked about this in my Amy Warren and the Meta of Magic in my season 8 coverage. Like, magic is really, really dangerous and it's powerful. And sure, Dark Willow is like the most powerful of any of the Buffy villains we've really come into contact with. She kind of beats Glory with the whole physical strength thing because, hey, she's like basically a god in her own right. But Angel, Faith, and Connor, they've never had to deal with Dark Willow. They've heard about her, sure, because hello, ultimate evil, but this is the first time that they are actually seeing Dark Willow. And so while Willow had protested that she can't just go home, she decides, no, I can't handle this dark, crazy magic just Let me go home because I will kill everybody if I stay like this. So the dingo demons clear a path so that Willow can be the first to go through the Terran reality back to Earth. But Angel says, look, Willow, I believe in you. You have to believe in yourself. And she is expressing this fear that she has. She's afraid of herself. But Angel says, look, you can do this. We came here to do this. We can do this together. We can be strong for each other. I need you to help us to keep Kortoth at bay. Angel asks if he thinks she can handle Kortoth, and she says, oh, I don't think that motherfucker can handle me. So Kortoth and Willow have this showdown, and basically Willow handles Kortoth because, hello, Dark Willow is the shit. So yay, everybody can go home, and Connor starts to try and run through the rift to get back home, and Willow's like, oh, no. I don't like that anymore. I'm changing the rules. I'm in charge now. So clearly this dark energy of Kortoth is getting the better of Willow. She puts a little bit more smackdown on Kortoth, and then she decides, hey, I think I want to keep Connor as my little pet. You know, you can be a great minion, you're so powerful, you know this place, you'd be a great right-hand man. I just need to, you know, get rid of your dad real quick. So while Willow's going off the deep end, acting crazy, Angel and Faith are like, we gotta stop this bitch. So Angel and Faith do the thing. Oh, and why am I forgetting it? It's where Colossus, like, throws Wolverine. Well, basically, Faith throws Angel up at Willow. Dark Willow, none too pleased. She's like, why don't you back the hell off of me? And Angel goes into Vamp Face and bites his bitch. But Willow actually really likes it. So he drains some of Willow's blood. She kind of like, whoa, and loses her kind of control and focus on the magics and everything. They fall out of the sky. And, you know, Faith and Connor are seeing what Angel and Faith's plan was to, you know, bite Willow. And Connor's kind of taken aback. He's like, oh, shit, Dad, what? Stop that. That's our friend. We don't do that. And at this point, as Faith and Willow had kind of, you know, guessed in issue number 2, Angel cannot go out of Vamp Face. The darkness of Kortoth, once he kind of puts Game Face on, it can't turn it off. And he tells Faith, kill me because this is going to get really bad. Like, if you think Dark Willow's bad, you don't want to deal with me. Kill me. But then Willow comes to and she says, hey, Angel, I'm going to be there for you just like you were there for me. We can do this together. Let's be happy. Thanks for saving me. Now it's my turn. And hey, Angel's able to get out of Game Face and back on team. Yay. So Angel and Willow have this moment where he tells her, I basically needed to bite you to activate your sense of euphoria so that you would kind of lose focus. And she says, I really appreciate that. And they have this moment where they talk about how Willow may not be, you know, hating Angel, but she's never going to be able to forgive him for these things that he did when he was Twilight. And that's okay. Like, it's okay to have these people in your life that don't make you happy and that you can't just forgive and forget. They still love each other, and that's the most important thing. So Willow opens up a portal to the world without shrimp, and all the dingo demons go through. They're so happy to have met their messiah, and they think Angel is Holtz, but, you know, they get to go scot-free into their new world away from the persecution of Kortoth. Willow is getting ready to go into some other world herself, and she is saying goodbye to everybody. She hugs it out with Connor, and she and Faith actually have this moment where Willow says, you have grown up so much. Like, you've grown more than any of us, and I'm really proud of you, and I'm really happy for you that you've come to this point in your life. And Faith and Willow are finally on this level that we really never expected to kind of see them be at, because there was all this animosity between the two since season 3. And so this is really nice. And what she says to Connor is also really nice. She's like, you are an amazing guy. Thanks so much for believing in me and seeing that the world is broken without magic. And you are going to be such a great man. And I'm really glad to see that you're going to be okay in this whole thing. So some stuff happens, people talk, and Willow gives Angel the piece of Giles's soul that is within the scythe, and wham bam poof, he's got one more piece. So yay happiness, but not quite, right? Because hello, Kortoth is still out there, right? So Connor, Faith, and Angel run back through the rift in reality, back into Kortoth, and the rift closes up, and everything seems to be a-okay. And they haven't really been gone that long. Remember how Kortoth's time is all wonky? Yeah, Gunn's coffee is still hot in the hotel. And Willow has gone off into another world to try and figure out how to bring magic to ours. Angel and Connor talk about how Angel's probably gonna go back to London because he's still got these things to do. But Angel says, you know what? I'm gonna stick around. I'm gonna hang out with you for a week because you're my son and I love you and I fucking miss you. And, you know, this whole thing has been about family and home. And, you know, Connor is Angel's only real home now. And so Faith, you know, she's not been thrilled about this whole thing. And she expresses to Angel, hey, this has been really crazy. And I told Willow that I would keep an eye on you. And he says, that's fine. Keep an eye on me because the rest of the pieces of Giles' soul are all in one place and we can go get them and then this will all be over. We're almost done, Faith. Yay. Okay, so then back in London, Nadira comes in to her little squad of slayers that she hangs out with and plays with, and it turns out that one of them has been killed. So yeah, when Drusilla was escaping from her whole mother superiorness, she apparently ran into some slayers and did some killing. And somebody spotted Angel in London around Drusilla when he was fighting off the mob while she was escaping. And somebody saw Faith fighting back to back with Angel. And Nadira is none too pleased with that because Faith has been lying to her the whole time. And that's where we end our issue. So, the first issue of this arc and the last issue of this arc are really good. They really put Angel and Willow at odds, and that's what's really the most important thing about this arc is Angel did this really awful thing, and Willow's trying to fix it, but in the fixing of it, she turns into this awful thing, and Angel, in trying to fix, you know, Giles, he's having to really stretch the limits of morality. He brought his son here and all this crazy, and he's kind of judging Willow for what she's trying to do, but she's also really judgy right back at him. And by the end, for them to help each other out and see the darkness and the goodness in one another, it's really important for these characters to reconcile. And what I really like about Angel and Willow is where we see them in season 10 of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, after they've gone through this and they've, like I said, reconciled these differences between them and seen that life is crazy and magic is crazy and there are all these consequences, but they are both actively trying to do right by the world and each other ultimately. And so that's where this whole arc really shines, is having these characters who have all of these problems and interpersonal conflicts able to overcome them and say, that's fine as long as we stick up for each other and get each other's backs at the end of the day. That's the most important thing. Faith actually gets to be really funny in this issue. If you pick it up and check it out, you'll totally understand what I'm talking about. She just gets a bunch of good one-liners, and a lot of people don't think that Faith is very funny, but I find Faith to be hilarious. It's nice to see Angel say, hey, you know, I realize I've got this whole larger-than-life mission, just like I always have, but I'm gonna sit here and play with you in LA for a little while, Connor, because I really have missed you. And like I said in number two, it's really nice to see Angel as a good father, as a reminder to the audience that Angel is a parent and he's not the worst one that we've got in the Buffyverse by far, which is, it's actually really nice for Angel. It's not something that I think about a whole lot, his being a parent, because Connor's so very absent for most of Angel's story. And so this is just a really nice way to kind of punctuate that relationship and say, yes, we are still here. Angel is still trying to actively participate in his son's life. It's always nice to see Dark Willow, and the only thing that I think that they could have done more with this arc is give us two issues with Dark Willow. I feel like it would have raised the stakes a little bit more, and it's fun to have Dark Willow around. But spoiler alert, we will see Dark Willow again before the end of season 9, so yay. But yeah, and it's good for Willow to think that she was immune to the darkness of Kortoth because of her magics, when, hello girl, you know magic is a whole mixed bag of tricks, so come on, you know, she got dark. And it's fine, and I like that Angel kind of also gets stuck in this darkness, and like I said, he and Willow are able to pull each other out of these funks. And again, Gunn gets the shortest end of every stick. He's here for like 3 frames and then holla back Gunn. But I don't know. I really want to see more Gunn going into the future, but I really don't know how they are going to do that. I don't think that Gunn would be a bad addition to Buffy, actually. I think that he would provide a really neat flavor into the mix because he's there in California, like, take a drive down the coast and come see us. So that's pretty much all I've got for today, you guys. I hope you're having a great 2015 so far. You can come right back here to the Buffington Post anytime for Buffy the Vampire Slayer reviews, Angel and Faith reviews, Buffyverse discussions, discussions on the other Slayers, and more. You can check out my playlists. If you haven't watched The Leftovers, go watch it and then come and watch my season 2 reviews. Next, we will be doing the pit stop number 3 and talk about what's at stake in the Buffyverse before we move into the next arcs, which will include Spike, Willow, Illyria, more Buffy, more Angel and Faith. Ugh, season 9 is going to get much bigger from here. So, have a great day, and we will see you next time. Bye. Got a black magic woman. Got a black magic woman. I've got a black magic woman. Got me so blind I can't see. That she's a black magic woman. She's trying to make a devil out of me. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Don't turn your back on me, baby. Yes, don't turn your back on me, baby. Stop messing around with your tricks. Don't turn your back on me, baby. You just might pick up.